boys and girls. Welcome to my music class. I was just listening to some of my very favorite music. Would you like to listen with me? Great. Here, listen. Do you hear it? It's beautiful, isn't it? It's actually by one of my very favorite composers, Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart. He lived a long time ago. He was born in 1756. You know what's amazing about him is that even though he was born so long ago, his music is still just as popular today as it was back then. You know what I wonder? I wonder what it would have been like to live in 1756. But you know what I always say? If you can dream it, you can do it. Come on, let's go.
Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart was an Austrian composer, instrumentalist, and music teacher. But before he was ever a man, he was a little kid, just like you. He was born in Salzburg, Austria, on January 27, 1756. He was the youngest child of Leopold and Anna Marie Mozart in a little but comfortably placed home in a cozy neighborhood. His father, Leopold, was a well-known violinist and composer in the employ of Archbishop of Salzburg. From a very early age, the young Mozart showed great musical talent. He toured Europe with his parents and older sister, Nannerl, who was also very musically talented, for several years, performing for royalty and the aristocratic elite. He could play the harpsichord and violin at the age of 5. And he was already beginning to write small pieces of music, just like his papa. You might even recognize one of them. Here, listen. Do you know what it is? You're right, it's Twinkle Twinkle Little Star. Also, the ABCs, or Ba Ba Black Sheep. Did you know those were the same song, and it was written by Mozart? Mozart soon grew into a man. He fought hard to become a well-known composer, failing many times, but never giving up. Mozart and his wife were not very good with money, so they were often very poor. But there was no shortage of work for Mozart. He wrote pieces for orchestras. Oh, look, a violin! Oh, and a timpani! Oh, that's my favorite kind of drum! Mozart also wrote operas and gave concerts. The audiences in Vienna weren't very supportive of Mozart. So Mozart went off to Prague, where audiences loved him. His operas, Marriage of Figaro and Don Giovanni, were a major success. There are several stories about Mozart's last illness and death, and it's not easy to be sure what happened. He was working on an opera, The Magic Flute, which is one of his best works and a very popular opera today. At the same time that he was working on this, he was asked by a stranger to compose a requiem. He was told to write it in secret. At the end of September, The Magic Flute was given its first performance. Mozart then worked very hard at the requiem. He must have realized that he was already very ill, and that in a way the requiem, a mass for the dead, was for himself. He died in Vienna before he could finish it, and Constance asked another composer to finish the work for him. Mozart was buried in the St. Mark Cemetery, forever known as one of the world's greatest composers.
Oh, boys and girls, I don't think I can live in this century. I'm not cut out for it. Wearing these kind of clothes all day long? Oh, no, I want to go back. Maybe if I just close my eyes, I'll dream myself back. Oh, thank goodness. Oh man, I thought I was going to be dressed like that forever. Wait, do you guys hear that? It can only mean one thing. It's singing time! Come on, let's go!
yum yum. One jumped into the pool where it was nice and cool. Now there are three speckled frogs. Ribbit, ribbit. Three little speckled frogs sitting on a hollow log eating the most delicious bugs. Yum yum. One jumped into the pool where it was nice and cool. Now there are two speckled frogs. Ribbit, ribbit. Two little speckled frogs sitting on a hollow log eating the most delicious bugs. Yum, yum. One jumped into the pool where it was nice and cool. Now there is one speckled frog.
Wait, wait, only one? Oh, that's so sad. He's probably so lonely.
I didn't see you there. I really enjoyed those timpanis so much that I thought maybe I would take out my own drums and start playing. Do you guys want to play with me? Oh, great. Okay, so I'm going to take this mallet and I'm going to play a steady beat. Do you feel it? Steady beat, steady beat, steady beat, steady beat. You know it's a steady beat because it stays constant, kind of like a heartbeat. Well, at least I hope your heartbeat is constant. It would be kind of bad if it wasn't. And if it's not constant, I suggest you tell your parents right away and get to a doctor, because that's bad news bears. Anyway, so the steady beat is kind of like the heartbeat of music. See how it stays the same? Steady beat, steady beat, steady beat. Can you tap the steady beat on your lap? Okay, well, let's get started with the game. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit a steady beat on this drum. If it's a steady beat, I want you to shout out, steady beat. And if it's not a steady beat, I want you to say, not a steady beat. Okay, you guys ready? Listen closely, because I might try and trick you. What do you guys think? Yeah, you're right. It's a steady. Good at this. I'm gonna have to make these harder. Okay, listen closely. What do you think? Yeah, you're right. That was not a steady beat, not even close. All right, how about this one? Listen closely. What do you guys think? You're right, it is a steady beat. I just played it slowly that time. Good job. All right, listen to the end. Is this a steady beat or no steady beat? What do you think? No steady beat, you're right. I played it too fast at the end. It didn't stay consistent. It wasn't constant. It wasn't a steady beat. You're very good at this game. That's awesome. How about this one? Are you guys ready? Here we go. What do you think? No, that wasn't wasn't a steady beat. It had a steady beat, but it didn't stay the same. That actually was a rhythm. We'll talk about that later on. Thanks for playing with me today, boys and girls. I had a lot of fun. Let's see what else we have in mind.
It's story time.
Never Play Music Right Next to the Zoo by John Lithgow. Illustrated by Lisa Hernandez. I went to a concert when I was a lad, no older than many of you. I sat with my sister, my mother, my dad, at a bandshell right next to the zoo. The soft summer air was so balmy and sweet, and the program was running so long, that I found myself falling asleep in my seat, despite all the music and song. All at once, the conductor erupted with rage. A band of wild animals was storming the stage. Oh, children, remember, whatever you may do, never play music right next to the zoo. They'll burst from their cages, each beast and each bird, desperate to play all the music they've heard. The lions and the elephants, the bears and the raccoons, will steal away the trumpets, the flutes, and bassoons. Replace the musicians and chase them away. Then they'll sit in the bandshell and play. The monkeys played fiddle, the bison played bass, the percussions were manned by the camel. The yak played the sax until red in the face, a surprisingly musical mammal. The bonobo played oboe, the ferret the flute, the jackal attacked the bassoon. The hippo had chosen the tuba to toot by the light of the silvery moon. Siberian tigers, Mongolian goats, a superabundance of bestial notes. As the animal orchestra filled up the air with chaos, confusion, and clatter, the audience calmly continued to stare as if nothing at all was the matter. I trembled with terror, suppressing a scream, while my parents just sat there, enraptured. Oh, how I wish it was only a dream, and those creatures all safely recaptured. But since by the minute I'd grown less afraid, I decided to sit back and watch while they played. They finished and each put their instrument down, then bowed and descended the stage. Each shed his tuxedo, or evening gown, and hurried back home to his cage. Then each reminisced, so grateful and glad, so full of contentment and pride. My mother, meanwhile, strolled away with my dad, but my sister remained by my side. She tugged on my sweater and spoke in my ear.
You better wake up, or we're leaving you here.
Oh, children, remember, whatever you may do, never play music right next to the zoo. They'll burst from their cages, each beast and each bird, desperate to play all the music they've heard. No, never play music right next to the zoo, and pay strict attention to rule number 2. Bear it in mind for the rest of your days. Don't fall asleep when an orchestra plays.
Thanks for joining us today, boys and girls. Make sure you watch all the way to the end of this video so you can answer the secret question. I gotta know what the secret message is from you guys today. But I like to end all of my music classes a certain way. We have to sing the goodbye song. Will you sing it with me? All right, here we go. Go ahead and just sing along if you know the words. If not, we'll sing it twice. Goodbye, goodbye, goodbye. Here we go. together.
Hey there, secret agents. Thanks for hanging around to the end of our music lesson today. I'm sleuthing around looking for some more information. Today we learned about a steady beat, and we learned about the beautiful music of Mozart. We even dreamed about what it would be like to live in the 1700s with him. But I need some more information from my gumshoes. The secret question today is, what do you want to be when you grow up? Answer below in the comments, and let me know that you joined our music class today. That's all I've got for today, boys and girls. That's my cue to do some more sleuthing. I better get going. I'll see you the next time on my music class.